Bonjour, nous sommes Pierre Balblanc. I was curator for Documenta 14 the last 3 years. And before I ran an art center in the suburbs of Paris called CAC Bretigny. And this tour will be followed by a presentation of a publication at 4 p.m. if you want to join about this art center in the opposite side of the fair in the Salone something. Salotti. Okay. So I pass the mic to my friend Andrea.
Hello, buongiorno. My name is Andrea Fustinoni. I'm a collector based in Santa Margherita. Together with my partner Fabio, we started our collection 15 years ago, and the collection goes from video, photography, to sculptures and small art installations. About 2 years ago, we established a no-profit organization, Miramart, with the purpose to promote contemporary art, through conversation and small exhibitions and in something connected with contemporary art.
So the gallery is called Rossi Rossi, based in London and Hong Kong.
Well, the gallery opened in 1987, and we deal with classical art from the Himalayas, so Nepal, North India, Tibet. And in 2005, we started the contemporary side of the gallery with a group of Tibetan artists that you can see in this side of our stand. And our collectors really enjoy the contemporary program, so we decided to continue that, and we expand our interest to other area. So now we have artists not only from Tibet or from those areas, but also from Pakistan, like Rashida Rahim, or Cambodia or Singapore.
Thank you. Wish is to give you a kind of short view on Rashida Rahim, who is born in 35, in Pakistan, and he moved to London quite early in the 70s, but before he did several works in Pakistan based on drawings and abstraction. He is basically one of the first to bring abstraction from the oriental side, non-occidental point of view on abstraction and minimalism. So here you have one of the structures that he designed quite early about a kind of system of combination of structure of works that maybe we can see better here on some catalogs. Try to show you this emblematic works based on cubes, sculpture cubes that are allow for the visitor to move and to combine. It is the meaning, a counter proposal from minimalism, who is basically based on distanciation and a kind of a distance with the viewers. These cubes are much more made to be manipulated and organized by the visitors, by the viewers, and create different shapes. This is coming from early drawings that are here. For example, inspired by hula hop display made by kids in Pakistan, and he designed a lot of drawings. He drew a lot of drawings based on that, and this is a bit the inspiration about his abstraction. But another side of his work is based on bringing into this abstraction, because here you see the shape very formal, very organized in a grid. He introduced content through images and through material in order to connect this abstraction with a kind of signification. On the contrary, from abstraction, which was used to put aside or put away a sign or signification. Here, it is a kind of a tension between a very strong grid and a content that relates mostly to his situation in Occident, in London, for example, here we see a configuration of policemen that are guarding a protest from the extreme right, in which people were killed. Pakistanis people in London, and these policemen are trying to make the interface between the protest and the people. And at the center, you see a kind of stereotype of Pakistanis or Oriental woman, which is present in a restaurant in London to depict the exotism of the Oriental. So this is a kind of very early 70s. You have to also put this in the context of the 70s, because at that time the what is very important here is to really consider the aesthetics of these pieces that are shown now here for the first time since a long time. The same as that piece about racism and about colonization. Here you have advertising of women were very predominant in Pakistan, and for selling cream to be white, to be more white. And so you have here the effect of the cream on the face. So it's really something that was strongly involving a relation between Orient and Occident through advertising. And this was something that created also problem for the skin, for the people, because the people didn't really support this kind of cream. And it was a kind of way to demonstrate the paradoxical situation with the culture. Another kind of play with stereotypes is this one, which is based on the landscape, very idealistic landscape in Pakistan, showing a kind of very ideal nature. But this nature is just here depicted for the rich people who can enjoy this landscape. And in the middle, you have a traditional watercolor made by farmers who depict their own village. And you have a contrast between the way the poor people depict the landscape and the rich people pretend to get and to enjoy the environment.
Prima di tutto vorrei dire che la Galleria Vista Mare è una delle tante gallerie che sono geograficamente collocate in una zona fuori dalle grandi scene dell'arte internazionale italiana. E ciò nonostante, queste gallerie hanno la caratteristica di investire una grande energia sul loro programma, sul loro lavoro, proprio per essere porsi al centro di questa scena da cui sono geograficamente marginali. Noi abbiamo conosciuto questa galleria per il lavoro di Ettore Spalletti e tutto quello che rappresenta nell'arte minimale, ma il lavoro più importante, secondo noi, è il lavoro di Rosa Barba, che è una delle più interessanti e giovani artiste italiane, lei comunque è di base a Berlino. Come vi dicevo prima, la nostra collezione è principalmente basata sulla fotografia, ma anche su tutte le espressioni della fotografia, quale può essere il video o può essere la fotografia concettuale. E il lavoro di Rosa Barba in qualche modo richiama un lavoro dell'immagine. Questo lavoro che in questo momento è in fase di... c'è stato uno sbalzo di temperatura, quindi il lavoro si è un attimo bloccato, però comunque resta in ogni caso molto interessante perché è un film che a differenza, ecco, ha ripreso a funzionare, che a differenza dei film normali che sono regolati dal fattore umano, questo è la macchina che decide di volta in volta da che punto partire e che cosa proiettare. Quindi è autonoma rispetto all'elemento umano ed è uno dei lavori veramente più interessanti nel panorama artistico. Rosa Barba è reduce da una grande esposizione all'Hangar Bicocca, una delle tante che ha fatto. E lo stesso discorso anche questo, se Benedetta, questo lavoro è un rullo.
Buongiorno, lei ha preso, Rosa Barba ha preso tutti i caratteri tipografici di questa tipografia che stava chiudendo e poi li ha impressi su questo rullo di cera, poi ha bagnato il rullo di cera nell'inchiostro e lo ha passato sulla carta, quindi è proprio l'idea di questo oggetto che racchiude anche un mondo, che è tutto il mondo letterario, il mondo linguistico, ma anche un mondo che è quello tipografico che sta sparendo, diciamo.
The relation between Rachid Harin and Céline Condorelli is possible to link through this use of abstraction. As Rachid do try to involve minimalism or abstraction into a kind of a participation and a combination. Céline is also trying to investigate in patterns that are used by architects or by urbanism in order to reinvest this shape or pattern into spaces that are used by people, basically. And here we have a first element that she did inspired by Beobardi, Lina Beobardi, from Brazil, who investigates in her museographical project this kind of element. So this, maybe you can explain a little bit more where this don came from.
Céline Condorelli is always kind of like remaining to architecture because she actually studied architecture. This booth is, she thinks that culture should be in everyday's life, so this booth is kind of like a statement about this idea. So one of the main references in her work is the work by Lina Bobardi. So as he said, these forms that you can see in this sculpture, in this portal, are remaining the windows of the Sex Pompeia, the Museum of Contemporary Art in Sao Paulo. So this shape that you can see here is the shape of a window, is actually this size, the windows of the building. And you can also see it in this one, this shape, it's another one. And also in this yellow piece that is done with masking tapes. So the thing is that this show is about the idea of playgrounds, because she thinks that culture should be in everyday life, as I said. So if we want to change that, we should start from the kids. So education is fundamental for this. So for example, in these works, we can see like three different elements or references of Céline's research. So this one is about Lina Bobardi. So here we can see her statement when she did this this building, this museum. This was starting point, and it was like a museum should have a collection, popular art and playground, but with no hierarchy. So they should be like these three elements or these three levels at the same point. And then a work about Aldo Baneg, that he was an artist, an architect, that he developed this project between the 40s and the 70s. And he did 140 playgrounds for the city of Amsterdam. And he would just develop them when the neighborhood would ask for one. So here you can see archive images of the different methodologies that he used. He used this kind of like geometric forms that, I mean, they were like pretty simple and pretty minimal in a way, but it's because his idea was to develop playgrounds and carousels that wouldn't force you to interact with them in a specific way. So you would have like kind of like different ways of playing with them in a way. So this is a work that it's about, that it also has archive images of a project that Pelle Nielsen did in the year 68. It was a show that he did for the Modern Museum of Stockholm. And what he did was he emptied all the museum and he transformed it into a huge theme park. So actually during those 4 months, just kids will be allowed to go inside of it. So it was kind of like an anarchy project. Here you can see adults, but they were just allowed to go inside just in the opening. But during those 4 months, just kids were there. And here you can see two sketches of carousels that Céline Condorelli developed for the Sex Pompeia last year. And right now there are two versions of them that are shown in right now in Strom den Haag in Netherlands. So he did these two, like they're like quite big actually, and they are like spinning carousels. When the show is finished, that is going to be finished like in a couple of weeks, these two carousels are going to be part of public schools of the city.
I just want to underline that Céline is all the time weaving, interlacing all the elements of her work, so models, reproduction, references, real objects are all together to make a kind of landscape in which you are invited to basically go and enjoy the shape and the references from history to now. So compared to Rachid, it's a very interesting dialogue in a matter of abstraction. So let's now go follow with the next one.
Il lavoro di Uriel Orlov si basa principalmente, come già suoi lavori precedenti, quali Double Vision o Grey, Green and Gold, sulle piante. Le piante che hanno una funzione quali testimoni, in questo caso specifico, testimoni di fatti sociali e storici successi in Sudafrica. Ogni pianta è stata al centro di un evento del Sudafrica, come ad esempio l'invasione dei portoghesi o le lotte contro lo schiavismo. Ogni pianta è messa in connessione con una situazione politica e storica, come se fossero dei fantasmi del passato che oggi ci ricordano che cosa è stato in quel dato paese. Uriel è un giovane artista israeliano che vive in Inghilterra e le sue espressioni artistiche vanno appunto dal video alla fotografia alle installazioni ed è veramente un percorso molto interessante perché è un progetto che continua nel tempo fin dai suoi primi lavori. Uriel è rappresentato da Corrado Gugliotta, come vi dicevo sempre questo filone di queste gallerie che sono geograficamente collocate al di fuori dei grandi circuiti. Corrado, ci vuoi aggiungere qualcosa su Uriel?
Questa mostra, questo grande progetto che lui ha sviluppato negli ultimi 2 anni, si chiama Teatrum Botanicum e ha a che fare appunto sulla vegetazione, sulle piante, la vegetazione, il mondo vegetale come un altro possibile filtro per studiare per analizzare fenomeni sociali di carattere più complesso. In particolare queste foto che vedete qui, che si chiamano The Memory of Trees, la memoria delle piante, è stato realizzato durante una residenza che l'artista ha fatto in Sudafrica e queste due piante, come diceva Andrea Fustinoni sono state in qualche modo appunto testimoni o comunque sono state caricate di significato da eventi che hanno avuto a che fare con delle storie di carattere umano. Okay? In particolare questa pianta che era il pioppo lombardo era famosa ed era a Johannesburg, era conosciuta perché veniva indicata delle persone che scappavano per problemi, perché erano implicate nella lotta contro l'apartheid e che dietro quest'albero c'era questa casa di questo signore che era stato il fondatore del Partito Comunista Sudafricano che normalmente dava asilo a queste persone, quindi quando bisognava trovare questa casa diceva dovete cercare questo grande pioppo che è il pioppo lombardo, lì dietro ci sarà sta casa e trovate queste persone che vi aiuteranno, per dire. Invece quest'altra pianta sembrerebbe essere una pianta di mandorlo, così mi dicono, e era stata piantata tanti anni fa, era stata piantata nel 1600 perché praticamente c'era questo signore che era un olandese, che era un colonizzatore, aveva una proprietà e aveva degli indigeni che gli davano fastidio, voleva delimitare la sua proprietà e aveva piantato una. Quindi spesso le piante servono come barriere, come venivano utilizzate come per definire delle proprietà, quindi vi potete immaginare insomma quanta complessità c'è nel mondo vegetale. Anche per esempio è molto interessante se visitate, poi chiudo, visitate la mostra che c'è al PAV, perché c'è anche un discorso per esempio sulla nomenclatura, cioè sull'attribuire il nome alle piante o su chi ha il potere di attribuire il nome alle piante, su quanto questa possa essere, come dire, uno strumento di colonizzazione, perché spesso le piante sono nate in determinati posti e poi sono state spostate e in base a come hanno viaggiato, questa cosa ci racconta altro e ci racconta dinamiche di potere.
Another two Italian artists I would like to speak about. One is Radi Martino, that Pierre also knows very well, and about the project of The Swimmer. Do you remember the movie The Swimmer with Bar Lancaster? C'era Bar Lancaster che attraversava a nuoto tutte le piscine degli amici per raggiungere casa. Ed era un film bellissimo che mi ha colpito molto quando ero ragazzo. E questo è un progetto che nasce sulla falsa riga di The Swimmer e mi affascina molto questa reinterpretazione partendo da questo spunto, da questo film, da questo romanzo, da questa novella di John Cheever che vi consiglio di leggere. Mi è piaciuto molto questo spunto come è stato reinterpretato dall'artista.
It was presented at the festival in Venice last September, and all the images are taken directly from the set. Okay. It's not a still frame, but it's a real photo.
Okay. And so it means that she edited different swimmers in different contexts.
Yes. Yes. Exactly.
And you have the images. Like the photo.
These are, you know, the idea was this man going back home, not walking but swimming in different swimming pool and in artificial
landscape.
Lake.
Yeah.
And with the same actor and also Filippo Timi and Valeria Golino, who are quite famous actors in Italy. Of course, both decided to participate to this project for free, also because the production cost could be very, very high if you have to pay the fee to the famous actor. And also the sculptures, the two palms, are the sort of combination of the stativo, and which is used, you know, for the lights, for the funnels, and the real palma.
And then I would like to end our conversation with my friend Pierre, introducing him an Italian artist, Claudio Alosi, with this minimal work. This minimal artwork that is beautiful, is a kind of a bronze, so seems delicate, but is very, very strong. Artwork has a beautiful energy with some insect in silver, and I was fascinated by this work, and I wanted to introduce you to Claudia for this reason. Yes, thank you for being with us, and enjoy Artissima.